In this segment, we're going to find an exact solution to a first order ordinary differential equation. So first order ordinary differential equation, we're going to find the exact solution to it by using our classical solution techniques of finding the homogeneous part and the particular part. So we're taking a first order ordinary differential equation with fixed coefficients, and we're going to find out what the exact solution is. So let's suppose somebody gives me a differential equation like this, 3dy by dx plus 6y is equal to 12 e to the power minus 2x with the initial condition y sub 0 equal to 5. So somebody's giving me a differential equation like this and wants me to find out y as a function of x. So again, the coefficients are constant, 3 and 6 here. I'm going to use the classical solution techniques of finding the homogeneous part and the particular part. I'm going to write down this equation, this differential equation, in the form of the differential operator. I'm going to 3d plus 6 operating on y is equal to 12 e to the power minus 2x y sub 0 equal to 5. And the reason why I wrote it like this is because this, by writing in an operator form, I directly get what the characteristic equation is. So I got to find the homogeneous part of the solution. So the characteristic equation is 3m plus 6 equal to 0. 3 times m plus 6 is equal to 0 is the characteristic equation, which is going to give me the homogeneous part, help me to find the homogeneous part. This gives me m is equal to minus 2. So what that means is the homogeneous part of the solution is k e to the power minus 2x. That is the homogeneous part of the solution, which means the homogeneous part of the solution, meaning that if I plug this homogeneous part in the solution into my differential equation right here, I'll get 0 as the solution. Now, let's go and see what the particular part should be. Now, you got to realize that the particular part is going to be of the form of the right-hand side. In this case, it is some constant multiplied by e to the power minus 2x. So the particular part is going to be some form of e to the power minus 2x and all its possible derivatives. And we know that derivatives of e to the power minus 2x are just e to the power minus 2x again, e to the power minus 2x again. So the form itself and derivative itself are of the form e to the power minus 2x. But one of the things which you are seeing here is that the homogeneous part of the solution is k e to the power minus 2x. So I cannot choose my particular part. I cannot choose my particular part to be of the form a e to the power minus 2x. So I have the form of the right-hand side and its derivatives is the form of e to the power minus 2x. So somebody might say, hey, then the particular part should be of this particular form. But I cannot choose this to be the form of the particular part of solution because the homogeneous part looks like that. And since the homogeneous part, by substituting it into the differential equation, gives me 0, I cannot have 0 equal to 12 e to the power minus 2x. So that's why what I would do is I have to choose the next possible independent solution would be ax e to the power minus 2x. I'm going to get yp is equal to a times x times e to the power minus 2x. That will be my particular part of the solution which I should be choosing there. So let's go and see that what the value of a is. So we have y sub p. I've just established that this should be the form of my particular part of the solution. So now I'm going to plug it back into my differential equation, which is 3 d by dx of y, which is ax e to the power minus 2x here, plus 6 times y, which is ax e to the power minus 2x, is equal to 12 e to the power minus 2x. That's the right-hand side of the differential equation. That's how I'm going to find k. So a. So I'm going to take the derivative of this. This is by using a derivative of multiple of two variables here. I'm going to have 3. I take the derivative of x, I get 1, so I get a e to the power minus 2x plus a times x, and I take the derivative of this, and that's minus 2 e to the power minus 2x. So that's what I get as the derivative of this quantity here, plus 6 times a x e to the power minus 2x is equal to 12 e to the power minus 2x. I again do this, I get 3a e to the power minus 2x minus 6ax e to the power minus 2x plus 6ax e to the power minus 2x is equal to 12 e to the power minus 2x. So when I expand, this is what I get. And of course, this has to cancel with this, otherwise you won't be able to solve the equation. And you can get, from here, you're going to get 3a e to the power minus 2x is equal to 12 e to the power minus 2x. And that gives me a is equal to 4. So that is the particular part of the solution, is nothing but 4x e to the power minus 2x. It's ax e to the power minus 2x. I just found out that a is equal to 4. So I found out what the particular part of the solution looks like. So that's how you find it, find the particular part of the solution. So we know that the complete solution is the homogeneous part plus the particular part. That the complete solution is the homogeneous part plus the particular part. What is the homogeneous part? Homogeneous part is, which we just found out, was k e to the power minus 2x. Particular part we just found out to be 4x e to the power minus 2x. Now, what I have to do is, this is the complete solution now for the differential equation, but there is still one unknown, which is k, which I'm going to find out from my initial condition. I'm given that y sub 0 is equal to 5, so that makes it k e to the power minus 2 times 0 plus 4 times 0 e to the power minus 2 times 0. And that gives me 5 is equal to k, because e to the power 0 is 1, this gives me just 0, so k is equal to 5. So I get y is equal to k, I'm going to substitute 5, e to the power minus 2x plus 4x e to the power minus 2x. So what I've just shown you in this segment is just another example of solving a first-order ordinary differential equation with fixed coefficients, with constant coefficients. But in this case, we are using something, the example which I took purposefully, had the homogeneous part matching with the form of the particular part which you would have taken, but you had to take the next independent solution, otherwise it would have become part of the homogeneous part. And that's the end of this segment.